Copacabana, we continued by bus to La Paz, where we spent one full day planning our trip and contacting service providers. Eventually, a 12-hour night bus ride took us to the city of Tupiza, located 740 kilometers southeast from La Paz. We found our way to La Torre Hotel, with whom we had booked our tour. We were embarking on an epic journey over 1,000 kilometers by car. For the next 4 days, from Wednesday to Saturday, our guide Felipe drove us across the uninhabited Bolivian highlands, surrounded by vast ranges of mountains and volcanoes. There were some roads off the beaten path, with not much traffic. If one would get a flat tire there, it might take quite some time to get help, as there was often no mobile connection. It felt surreal to see such diverse landscapes. There were deserts with massive rock formations, many of them formed by volcanic activity. Some of the places looked like Star Wars. And we saw geysers rumbling and blasting out hot steam. It's good to note that this was in high altitude. According to our guide, we were in over 5,500 meters at some point. With the altitude also came the constant change in weather. Some hours it was raining, sometimes even snowing. And then suddenly the sky cleared. It was normally hot during the day and even some minus degrees during the night. These highlands are also a home for interesting wildlife. We have never seen so many flamingos who were feeding and resting on multiple lakes we drove by. There could be thousands of them in one place. In addition, we saw vicuñas, even a couple of the South American ostriches, but our favorites were the wild vicuñas, which are cautious wild animals, quite difficult to see from a close range. They are protected by law, so there is a severe penalty for harming them. We also found many llamas. They are so funny looking animals. Being stuck for 4 days in a jeep with total strangers is a bit like a lottery. We were lucky to spend these 4 days with Silvia and Sabrina, a friendly and fun mother and daughter team from Switzerland. Our travel crew also had a chef who cooked us homemade breakfast, lunch and dinner throughout the tour. She was a talented cook, also knew how to prepare delicious vegetarian food. The 3 nights we spent in simple guest houses. The last night was in a hotel made of salt. The salt flats of Uyuni are Bolivia's grand jewel. Many people travel directly from La Paz to Uyuni and spend their tour exploring mainly the salt flats. We were so happy of our choice to start the tour from the less crowded Tupiza and see the exciting southern parts first, before ending up in the salt flats. For the first 2 days, there were close to none other tourist groups. During the last 24 hours, we finally entered the famous Salar de Uyuni. Due to the rainy season, the salt flats are closed for tourism from late December, at least for some months, as the jeeps will get stuck if there's too much water. Fortunately, we were still able to see it, even though it was mid-December. Though we didn't see much of the famous night sky due to the weather, but that's life. The 10,000 square kilometers of salt flats is such a mind-blowing area that we hadn't realized it fully before getting there. The salt reaches up to 130 meters in depth. As we are used to seeing frozen white lakes and Baltic Sea in Finland, this view was tricking our brain to think we are back home. Perhaps the most absurd out-of-this-world place was Incahuasi, a volcanic island in the middle of the salt flats, filled with huge cactuses. What the heck is this place? We were thinking while eating a freshly baked cake for breakfast. Before the tour ended in the town of Uyuni, we went to see one more south hotel and also were offered a chance to buy some tourist photos as a service. It felt so prepackaged and touristic that we decided it's better to skip it. But then, whoops. $30 for a bunch of funny photos and videos. We went for it just like everyone else. There wasn't too much to see in the town of Uyuni itself, except the graveyard of old trains. We took some album cover photographs of Riikka in case she ever decides to start her career as a rap artist. There were some insane transformers as well. To skip the bus companies with bad reviews, we had booked the expensive Todo Turismo bus to take us back to La Paz. It was 36 euros per person, including a small dinner and a breakfast. The price tag for this adventure with La Torre Tours was 1,250 bolivianos for the tour, plus 220 bolivianos for the national park entrance fees. So in total, around 200 euros per person. This tour from Tupiza to Uyuni turned out to be one of the clear highlights of our aventura in South America so far.
Death Road Survivor tai jotain sinne päin. Katsotaan, että selvitäänkö lopulta perille asti. Sieltä tultiin ihan jäätävällä vauhilla. Liukkaita kiviä ja meikä mandoliini.
Että kunnon pannu.
Let's go.